Most of us have only seen a shuttle lift off from the outside looking in. But UK alum and former astronaut Story Musgrave is one of the few to know what it's like to be on the inside looking out.
Before you go into space, you think, you know, you imagine Earth in your memory as a geography book. But then the geography book gets replaced by the real thing. And it's very beautiful. It's very exciting.
A feeling, he says, never got old, even as he became the only astronaut to fly on all five space shuttles.
It's the zero G. It's what you see out the window, and it's getting the job done. And, you know, the experience, the enjoyment, the experience of it.
When the Hubble telescope needed critical repairs, NASA called on him to figure out how the astronauts could work on it in their spacesuits.
I knew how to make working in a suit, a bulky suit, you know, not got the same body and zero G. I made the job easy.
A job he didn't just plan for, but actually did. As he and his colleagues fixed Hubble. Musgrave says his success in space started out in his early years on a farm and in the military.
I was a grease monkey. I was heavy equipment grease monkey between the farm and the Marines. And you say, you know, well, that's not going anywhere. Yeah, it's going to fix telescope. Because no one else brought that set of skills.
Skills he honed at UK, his last stop before going to NASA.
Finishing medical school, I looked around, you know, well, I can come back to Lexington if they have an internship here. And so they did. It was the first internship class at UKMC, brand new place. And so that fit just beautiful. I read about where they're interested in flying scientists. And so the program hadn't happened yet, but I read that and I said, that's me. Everything I did in my life will fit on that job. So I told him at the end of the year I wouldn't continue with the surgery. So at that time, I joined the Department of Physiology, postdoc fellowship, and I got ready for the space program. And so I started my flying here, too. So this plays along with what I did at the university. When it came time to go into space, I was ready. There were a lot of grand professors. Ben Eisman, who was chairman of surgery, he was a real leader. So I was scrubbing on a case one day with him, and he says, "Story, yes, sir." I said, "You're not gonna be with me next year." I says, "I'm really gonna miss you." I says, "What are you gonna, you know, why not?" "Well, I'm going into space, sir." You know what he said? "How can I help?" He did not say that's a stupid thing. He did not say you're not gonna make it. You know, he didn't. I said, "I'm going into space, sir." In a flash, without even thinking, "How can I help?"
It was that encouragement and his entire experience here that means this accomplished astronaut will always have a special place in his heart for UK.
They got me off my surgical training, starting with internship. Their postdoc fellowship. They got my education in science and physiology, spaceflight physiology. They got my flying out the window here. When space came along, I got it all. So it was a very important part of the path. But it was part of the path. It was a fun part of the path, too.
A path that led this UK alum to a permanent place in space exploration history. For UK Now, I'm Amy Jones-Timoney.